Hello friends, in this video we will be solving get numericals based on finite state machine. Let us begin. The first question, which is from GET 2012, the question says the state transition diagram for logic circuit shown is, and the logic circuit is given, as you can see, a D flip-flop is driving 2:1 multiplexer and A is a select line. Output of multiplexer is again fed back to D flip-flop. If you refer the options, the state diagrams are given in terms of output Q. That is, this Q they are talking about, where the possible states of Q can be 0 or it can be 1. And if you refer the state diagram, you will come to know that output Q is controlled with the help of input A. So A is a control variable here. So A is a control variable. The possible value of control variable can be 0 or 1. So we have to see how Q changes when A is changed from 0 to 1 or 1 to 0, and we will see all possible values, how Q is changing. Possible value of Q is either 0 or 1. Therefore, if you refer all the options, you will come to know that Q can be 0, Q can be 1. So Q equal to 0 is one state, Q equal to 1 is the another state, and we may go from one state to the other state, or we remain in the same state. That totally depends upon the control variable status. So now we will see how to solve this problem. So on the next slide, as you can see, I have copied the same circuit diagram which was given. So we need to know what is the value of Q. We know that this value Q is output of D flip-flop, and we know that D flip-flop works on a principle that it just copies input to output. So I can say that Q next, that is nothing but a next state, is always equal to what? D. But as you can see, D is driven by output of multiplexer. So can I say that D is simply equal to Y? What is Y? Y is output of multiplexer. So as you can see, Y is output of 2:1 multiplexer. Am I right? I'm sure you remember multiplexer. So this is 2:1 multiplexer having input as I0 and I1, output Y, and select line is S0. For this 2:1 multiplexer, suppose if I want to express Y in terms of input, it has got a standard equation that Y is equal to S0 bar I0 plus S0 times I1. Is that right? So this is the standard way by which we write the equation for multiplexer. Why I'm so interested in equation of multiplexer? Because as you can see from this equation, it is quite clear. If you want to know what is the next Q value, you should know what is the value of Y. And as you can see, Y is output of 2:1 multiplexer. So for standard 2:1 multiplexer, I have written this equation. So this equation shouldn't be an issue if you have already studied a combinational logic circuit, in which we say when S0 is equal to 0, output Y is nothing but I0, and when S0 value is equal to 1, the value of Y is nothing but I1. So from this table only, we have got this equation. As you can see, the first case here, when S0 is equal to 0, output is I0. So S0 being 0, it is written as S0 bar dot I0 plus. Here, as you can see, S0 value is 1. So S0 is uncomplemented here dot I1. So this becomes equation of 2:1 multiplexer. Am I right? So observe very carefully. This is quite important. This is X0 and X1, meaning that this must be I naught, and this must be I1, and this is Y, and A is nothing but your S naught, that is slack line. Is that right? So now let us express Y in terms of I1, I naught, and S naught, that is X1, X naught, and so referring to this equation, I can write Y equal to S naught bar. In case of S naught, what we have is A. So I'll write A bar dot I naught. But here the value of I naught is nothing but X naught plus, then we have S naught, then I can write A dot I1, but in place of I1, what we have is X1. Also, I can write Y equal to A bar as it is. You can see that X naught is nothing but Q bar. So I can write Q bar plus A dot. As you can see, X1 is coming from Q. So I can write this equal to Q. We know that when A bar Q bar plus AQ is nothing but XNOR relation. So I can write Y equal to A XNOR with Q. Is that right? So now we have this simple equation. Y equal to A XNOR with, we know that your Q next is nothing but equal to Y. So now I can write Q next is equal to A XNOR with Q. So now based on this, I can write table of AQ versus Q next. So AQ can have possible values as 00, 01, 10, and 11. We know that the XNOR truth table, 0 XNOR with 0 is 1, this is 0, this is 0, this is 1. So now if I divide this into two part, what I can see here is A value equal to 0 and here A value equal to 1. Now try to get Q next in terms of Q here. As you can see, when Q equal to 0, Q next is 1, and when Q equal to 1, Q next is 0, which is nothing but a complement of Q, meaning that when one of the input is fixed to 0, output is complement of another input. So I can write here your Q next equal to Q bar when A equal to 0, and whenever A equal to 1, as you can see, Q next is same as Q. So here I can write Q next, it's same as Q. So this is important for us. When A equal to 0, Q next is Q bar, and when A equal to 1, Q next is equal to Q. So as we know, if A equal to 0, it says that Q next is Q bar, and whenever A is equal to 1, we have seen that Q next is same as Q, that is next state it's same as the previous state. So now we'll try to figure it out. What is the final diagram? I have two possible states. Q can be 0, so we have two possible states, that is Q equal to 0 and Q equal to 1, and control variable is A. So you can see here, when A equal to 0, Q next is Q complement. Okay, now how to understand this? It's very easy. See, let us assume the present state is Q equal to 0. You are in this state, that is Q equal to 0. If you apply A equal to 0, the next state is exactly Q bar, meaning that if I apply A equal to 0, if the present state is 0, next state will become 1. Vice versa is also true. Let us assume you are in this state, that is Q equal to 1, and if you apply A equal to 0, what is going to happen? It is going to complement it. So A equal to 1, you will move from Q equal to 1 state to Q equal to 0 state. I hope you are understanding this. Let us again assume that you are in this state, that is q equal to 0. And if you apply a equal to 1, we can see that when a equal to 1, q next is same as q, meaning that due to application of a equal to 1, you remain in the same state. Similarly, when q equal to 1, and if you apply a equal to 1, you are going to remain in a same state. We need to correct this. A has to be 0. Because a equal to 0 causes q next to become q bar. So when a equal to 0, 0 becomes 1 and 1 becomes 0, that is nothing but next state is equal to complement of previous state, and a equal to 1 causes state to remain unchanged. Therefore, if you refer now options A, B, C, D, you will find that option number D is matching with our thing. So option number D is the correct option. I'm sure you understood this problem. We'll try to summarize this problem again. See, we have to get the state transition diagram for the logic circuit shown. If you see all the options, it is in terms of Q only, right? So they have considered this output Q, where Q can have two possible states, Q equal to 0 and Q equal to 1. And if you refer all the diagrams, you'll understand that A is a control variable. So somehow I wanted to get an equation of Q in terms of A. So what we did, what we have seen, Q is same as D because it is nothing but a D flip-flop. But D is same as Y, where Y is output of 2 is to 1 multiplexer. So we used standard 2 is to 1 multiplexer equation, and then we expressed our Y in terms of A and Q. But since Y is nothing but Q next, so now we have written Q next is equal to A XNOR with Q. So according to this XNOR truth table, what we come to know that when one of the input of XNOR is equal to 0, because A being control variable, I have taken A over here, Q next is equal to Q complement, and when A equal to 1, Q next is same as Q. So assuming that, let us say you are in present state as 0, and if you apply A equal to 0, then it gets complemented. Therefore, as you can see, when you are in present state 0, okay, and if you apply A equal to 0, the next state is complement of this. So Q equal to 0 now becomes Q equal to 1. Let us assume that you are in Q equal to 1 as a present state, and if you apply A equal to 0, then the next state is equal to complement of the present state. Therefore, the arrow shown over here, where state is moving from right to left, so A equal to 0 causes to complement the state, whereas A equal to 1 causes to remain in a same state, because as you can see, Q next is equal to Q only when A equal to 1. So as you can see, option number D matches with this. So let us move to the next problem. The state diagram of a finite state machine is designed to detect an overlapping sequence of 3 bits. It's shown in the figure. FSM has input in and output as out. If input sequence is, which is 1010 11 01 00 1101, starting with leftmost bit, then number of times output will be equal to 1 is. So this is the question without option, which is generally referred to as NAT, which is numerical type question. In this, you have to enter only number of times out is becoming 1. So I'm sure you must have recognized this is nothing but your sequence detector. So you'll have to actually see what sequence it is trying to detect. And on top of this, they are also claiming that it is nothing but a 3-bit sequence detector. As you can see, it is claiming that it is a 3-bit sequence detector. That's the reason why, as you can see, there are total 4 states, because we have already seen that for 3 bits, we always have 4 states, right? But we used to name them as S0, S1, S2 and S3. So here, they have actually written S0, S1, S2 and S3. Generally, every state is assigned some value like 00, 01, 1011. But now for this problem, you can actually ignore this. Just ignore this, what is written inside the states. What is important to you is S0, S1, S2, S3 states. Now the problem is we don't know which input sequence it is trying to detect, right? Because we have worked on a problem like they used to give us the input sequence to be detected. Like we have designed sequence detector overlapping as well as non-overlapping for 010 and 1010 like that. So we don't know what sequence it is trying to detect. But in this problem, they have given us a state diagram and we have to identify the binary sequence which it is trying to detect. So first of all, we'll try for that. So as you can see, you have to observe when it is going from S0 to S1, when it is going from S1 to S2. Also, you have to observe from S2 at which bit it is going for S3. Let us observe. S0 is a reset state. It is going to S1 state only when in is equal to 1. So at input bit equal to 1, it is moving to S1. From S1, it is going to S2 at input value equal to 0. So S1 to S2 transition happens when 0 is given. From S2 to S3, as you can see, from S2 to S3 transition happens only when input equal to 1. And during that, out is equal to 1. So as you can see, 101 is the sequence that they are talking about. All right. So what I'll do is, this is the input sequence which is given to input of that FSM. And we have to see how many times out becomes 1. You know that out becomes 1 only when this 101 sequence gets detected. But we have to make sure that it is operating in overlapping sequence detection. So first of all, I need to copy what is given to us. The input sequence given as 101 011 0100 1101. So you need to just figure it out how many times you are getting 101. As you can see here, I'm getting 101. You have to use a concept of overlapping, so it is possible to get this 101 also. Again, I'm getting 101 here. Then overlapping is not possible, as you can see. And at the end only, I'm getting 101. So as you can see, this is first time, this is second time, this is third time, and this is fourth time. Every time 101 sequence is detected, output becomes 1. As you can see, it is detecting 101 in overlapping sequence 4 times. Therefore, output is equal to 1 for how many times? Of course, it is for 4 times. So answer is 4. So 4 is the correct answer. I'm sure you have understood this question. Let us move to the next question. You can see this is a latest question asked in GATE 2020 for EC branch. The state diagram is shown below. State S0 is initial state. This is nothing but S0. Okay, this is initial state. They're talking about this. If output is equal to 1, then, and some options are given, you can refer the options. So output is 1 when sequence is 01010 detected, or option B. As you can refer all the options, they are asking you what bit sequence it is trying to detect. So we will be using the same technique that we have used previously. So you have to just observe how it is moving from one state to the other state. You know that it is moved from one state to the other state only when the valid input bit is given. Am I right? So we just need to keep on tracing which bit it is trying to detect. And we have to also observe when output is becoming 1. When output is equal to 1, we have to stop there and there only, because that is the input bit sequence it is trying to detect. So let us see. You have to see carefully S0, S1, S2, S3, S4. So just try to see the transition. We have to keep on transiting until and unless we get output equal to 1. So see to it, it is going from S0 to S1 only when input is 0. As you can see here, I'm talking about this. Otherwise, it remains in S0 state only. So the sequence it is trying to detect, the first bit that I have got is 0. Then from S1 to S2, it is going under which condition? You can check. only when input is equal to 1. So the next bit, valid bit, is 1. Now if you start referring all the options, 0, 1 is there in all the options, right? So still we are unable to actually eliminate some options. All the options are matching till this. Just check it out when it is going from S2 to S3. It is moving from S2 to S3 only when the third valid bit is equal to 0. So S2 to S3 transition happens when the input bit is equal to 0. So third valid bit is equal to 0. So with 0, 1, 0, as you can see, option number C can be eliminated now. But still, 0, 1, 0 is present in option A, B as well as D. Let us move forward. S3 to S4. So as you can see, it is moving from S3 to S4 only when input is equal to 1. So next valid bit is equal to 1. But still, as you can observe, output is still 0. Output is not 1, right? Can you see that it is bouncing back to S3 state only when input equal to 0 and output equal to 1? So we need to consider this input equal to 0. So input equal to 0. Output has become 1 at this time. So now observe carefully what the sequence is. The sequence is 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. So if you observe carefully, it is option number A. So it is very simple. See, you don't have to really draw the state diagram and you don't have to go through every states. You have to just use a tricky method. For that, a concept should be known. So if the state diagram is given, see to it at what input bit condition it is moving from one state to the other. Keep on tracing all the bits until and unless you get output equal to 1, and you automatically get the bit sequence for which it is acting as a sequence detector, for which output is equal to 1. So I'm sure you are now quite comfortable with this finite state machine. We have solved ample amount of problems on finite state machine. And also we will solve more problems in next video lecture also. Thank you.